Shin Sung Chan up against Poon Lok Yan and Seung Ying Suet. Straight games wins all the way so far for Jung and Shin. Whereas Poon and Se have come from a game down in the quarters and the semis.
The fourth final match is now to begin, the women's double final. Let's welcome the technical officials.
So here come the line judges and umpire service judge for this women's doubles final. Koreans in fine form.
Let's welcome Yang Ki-yun and Jin Sing Chen from Korea.
Yeah, they were superb yesterday from start to finish against the Japanese pair of Matsuo and Naito. If they can find that form again today, they are going to be hard to beat for sure.
And let's welcome Poon Lok Yan and Si Ying Su from Hong Kong, China.
So, Poon and Si, their opponents, looking for their first win since reuniting in the spring. Hong Kong, Korea, it is indeed.
The umpire of today is Yip Bo-Lin from Macau, China.
So it's the women's doubles final.
John Philippe
Driven Shin up against
New
Poon and Si.
Enjoy the match.
Our umpire going through the preliminaries. That's Yip Bo-Lin from Macau. Swap of sides. So what sort of final are we going to get here? Can Poon and Si push this impressive Korean pair? Jung and Shin, as you can see, had a fight in the second round, but very impressive yesterday, 34 minutes only on court. Their third final in 3 months. They're looking for their second win. Originally came together as a pair about a year ago at last year's Hong Kong Open, but they didn't team up properly until September at the Japan Open. Poon and Si, well, as you can see, they had to fight back convincingly lost their opening game yesterday to Fukushima and Hirota, but fought back well. Confirmation, Yip Bo-Lin is our umpire. it's Jean-Philippe Berge who is our service judge. Jung and Shin. Shin in the picture here, the younger of the two. World junior champion with Sohee Lee on a couple of occasions. But as we saw with the mixed doubles, it's been a way forward, particularly looking to next summer's Olympics to put experienced with Lesso. And it's working well for the Koreans who already have the mixed doubles title in the bag. Chance coming up as well in the men's doubles with Ko and Shin. But Poon and Si have already knocked out the number three, the number eight seeds here this week. Now up against the number six seeds. Doubles final. And, well, they started fast yesterday, the Korean pair, and off to a very determined start, shall we put it. I really was impressed yesterday against a very experienced pair in Matsuo and Naito. They're up against another experienced pair here because Poon and Si have, of course, won at Super Series level, won the Japan Open back in 2012 against Matsuo and Naito. Talking about, we're in yesterday's semi-final. First Hong Kong women's doubles pair to win at Super Series level. That's out and long. They're off the mark. Nicely covered by Shin. Yeah, let me get the shuttle back, please. The umpire's chair. Confident start from Jung and Shin. Well, it's only the first 8 points, but already they appear significant. We shall see. Well, straight into the net from Jung Kyung Yun. Left and it was given in. Let's see, my instinct was that that was out, let's be honest, but listen, I can't get them right all the time and don't think our TV replay helps that much, but there you go. That certainly is out. Service fault called.
Service over 5-7.
Jean-Philippe Berge calling the serve too high. That's short. Oh, I missed.
Six, seven.
So, call goes against them. Service fault. Miss smash. And suddenly there's only a point back in it. Good flick serve as well from Poon Lok Yang. Tension out there. Fault. Service fault called against Poon this time. Tried the flick serve again. Now she looks to the umpire, it's the service judge that's given it. Jean-Philippe there, you can see. Oh. And now, a serve into the net from Jung. It's all become a little racket, hasn't it? Oh, now an indecision. Left it to each other, and it's proved costly. Well, they started so confidently, picking up where they left off from yesterday's semi-final, Jung and Shin, but they've looked a very different pair in the last 5 minutes or so. Again, look at that. Well, that helps. Goodness me. Good. So it's the pair from Hong Kong who take the interval lead in a, I have to say, a strange start to the match in some respects. Poon Lok Yan, Si Ying Suet with an 11-10 advantage. intriguing women's doubles final so far. Slight advantage to the pair from Hong Kong, who celebrate the mistake. Just wonder sometimes about celebrating an opponent serving into the net like that. Well, she's left it again. It's turning into a theme for Shin over there. This time it is wide. Credit to the pair from Hong Kong here. Come from a game down, 2 days running to be in the final. They've had some good weeks as well. When their opponents won in Denmark, they made the quarterfinals. A lovely tight net shot from C there. They then made the final last month at the Bitburger Open. Disappointingly, I suppose, lost in the first round of the Hong Kong Open last week, but they've made that short ferry ride across the Pearl River Delta. And another service fault. Jean-Philippe Berge, as far as the players are concerned, making a nuisance of themselves. The players disappointed. Again, it's just for serving above the ribs. Racket too high at the start position. Poon and Lok looking good here.
16-14.
Off to a slow start of the match. 6. 2 down they were, but 16-14 up now. But then again, they keep throwing in a serve into the net. A serve wide there or a service fault. I think that's 5 points they've given away on their serve without the opponents having to return. But there you go, there's one back. Have been in the top 10 of the world before, now ranked 21. Back together since the Uber Cup. Just to keep you updated with the score, lost the graphic in your corner, 1 point. In, as you can hear from umpire Ip Poolin, 17-16. Ah! 3 points away now from taking the opening game, Poon and Seat. That's on the line, well played. Right down the line. Poon finding the range, 19-16. No problem that time for Shin. Trying to claw her way back into this. It's game points for Poon and Seung. Well, what an opportunity for this Hong Kong pair to take this opening game now. Poon serving. Clash of rackets and it's wide. And Poon Lok Yan and Seung Suet are a game away from their first title of the year. Despite some serving problems and issues, they came through in the end, 21 points to 18. Game one goes to the pair from Hong Kong. So can Jung and Shin here find their form again? Kind of saw their confidence drain in that opening game, leaving shots that went in. Ever since they actually left one, it looked like it went out. And no way back after that. Completely missed time this time by Jung. Service moments. It's time for seat. Really well there, didn't she? Poon. Let's see, puts it long. Well, they came back together at the Suderman Cup, Poon and Seung, for the first time since late 2013. Their last tournament before their split was the Macau Open back in December 2013. Lost to the Luo sisters in the first round. Well, it could be a very different feeling a couple of years on. I think they've improved a lot since getting back together. communicate more and solve problems. And on court, I suppose it comes with maturity now, both 24. That's just come off the net and gone wide, though. No 2 days are the same, are they? Full flow yesterday against Nato Matsuo. But here against Poon and Si, things not going their way for Jung and Shin. They do have the advantage, though, in this second game right now. Finding it hard to get through their defense. Now they turn it around beautifully. The Hong Kong pair end up taking the point. So tight second game. Yeah, dead save, but the errors have seemed to disappear off the serves. Game far much more in a flow right now. And as I say that, well, Shin was trying to find the line, trying to play a winner. Put it wide. Parity in game two.
Service over.
I suppose Jung and Shin haven't won a final this year either, because when they reached the final of the Denmark Open, they were given a walkover off the floor there from C. And they end up winning the point. Pretty handy. Yeah, Jung and Shin won the Denmark Open. They were given a walkover in the final by Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei because of injury to their opponents. Did beat the number one pair in the world, though, en route to that final. To Tomo and Ayaka Takahashi. Well, it was 11-10 at the interval to the Hong Kong pair in game one. Going to be 11-10 to someone at the interval here. It is the pair from Hong Kong. Nice tight net shot. And Poon and C. Well, they're getting closer to winning this Grand Prix gold title. Yeah, good reactions. Nice flick off the net. 11-10 to the Hong Kong pair then in this second game. Good working of the net by Shin. Needs to do a lot more of that. Try and get them here in the ascendancy. Get them free flowing again. Flick serve. Not quite dispatched by the Hong Kong pair. Eventually it is by Poon. Not going to miss those. Just long from pushed long by Poon and missed opportunity. 12 all now. Wide. We're seeing some decent length rallies here, but bear in mind, I told you that Jung and Shin won the Denmark Open and that Poon and C made the quarterfinals, were in the second round against Fukuman and Yanao, who they beat here this week as well. They had a rally of just over 4.5 minutes, apparently a world record for the longest rally. 4.5 minutes. Nothing coming close to that in this match. Although this is a decent rally. Well, then again, it's funny how you say these things and then this happens. Oh. Into the net it goes from C. Longest rally of the match, though. As if by magic.
scored.
Service fault called. Time against the Koreans, and he's been busy, hasn't he, Jean-Philippe Berge? Oh, Shin can keep asking. She's not going to change her mind, is she, Ip Bulin? She wouldn't do that. Well, still edging it in this second game. Poon and Si, and still creeping towards the finishing line. It's been a while since someone's won 2 points in a row, though. Certainly haven't since the interval. Miss it. Pretty useful one though. Oh no. Oh dear. Poon Lok Yan is down and maybe out here. She is down in some pain. Oh my goodness. Well, terrible when this happens to anyone. Let's have a look again. She's just gone to play the overhead there. Oh my goodness. That's knee ligaments by the looks of it to me. I've seen that once or twice. You can see she's gone down holding her knee, and the way her leg went from underneath her, I'm pretty sure that's knee ligaments. Obviously I'm no doctor. You can hear the pain, but what I can tell you is I've suffered that myself and I know that pain. It is excruciating. I really feel for her here. Young lady who was in the middle of her studies when she decided to change her career path and come back to playing badminton to relive the Olympic dream. But if it is as severe as my initial prognosis, that is going to be damaging in all sorts of ways. Certainly wouldn't be able to carry on in this match, that's for sure. Let's hope it's not as bad as that assumption. She does look in terrible, terrible pain though. I'd be very surprised if she could carry on here. Well, what a pity. What a shame. Oh, it's incredible, isn't it? How fate decides things like this. I'm afraid they just need to get her off the court as gently as they can. I mean, for those who are a little squeamish, I'd look away really, because you can see when she goes to stretch for this, a leg goes from underneath her. It's an awkward fall and then, oh, I'll tell you what, I can't look at that again. Anyone who suffered that kind of injury will know the pain. Thankfully, she's sitting up a little bit now. There's no way, if it's knee ligaments, there's no way she can carry on, obviously. what happens is the pain starts to subside now. It goes from that pain where you feel like you're going to be sick to just bad pain. All we can do is wish her well, really. Trying to flex the knee here. Well, she can't get up. She can't get up. They need to get a chair or something to carry her off on, because they don't want to cause any other damage. She needs to get ice on it as quickly as possible. And probably off to the hospital just to get a checkup. But one would assume the knee will swell up pretty quickly here. Well, a horrible way to win the final. Tears for Poon Lok Yan. And victory of sorts for Jung Kyun Yun and Shin Sung Chan. And incredible, given the fact that they won the Denmark Open when their opponents didn't show because of an injury to the Chinese pair Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei. But a game up at 15-0. The Hong Kong pair looked like they were on the verge of victory there. But it's the Koreans who take the title. And all we can do is wish Poon Lok Yan well in terms of a speedy recovery from what looks a very nasty injury indeed. One minute you're flying and looking on the verge of your first win together as a pair in 3 years. The next minute you're down on the floor, match is over. Obviously disappointment for a partner as well. See Young Suet. Here comes the assistance that she requires. She's going to be in a lot of pain for a while. Some medication, I think, required. And the leg needs to be raised. You'd expect a warmer round of applause for Poon Lok Yan. But I don't want to be jumping the gun here, but that could be her Olympic dream for 2016 over. Disappointing end to an intriguing women doubles final. The title goes to Jung Kyung Yun and Shin Sung Chan. Well, obviously, I assume the winners only will be going up to get their medals here.
Oh, 係啊，不過見到即係在場嘅球迷啊，佢哋都好好啊，因為頭先見到啊運動員受傷嘅時候咧，佢哋都不斷用掌聲嚟鼓勵大家。多謝曬大家。好，各位球迷、各位觀眾、各位新聞界嘅朋友，2015澳門羽毛球格林披治黃金大獎賽頒獎典禮即將開始。
Honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, the awarding ceremony of women doubles of the 10th 2015 Macau Open Badminton, part of the BWF Grand Prix Gold Series, is about to start.
首先呢，我哋介紹頒獎嘉賓。
Let's introduce our honorable guests.
三位包括 澳門羽毛球總會會長兼2015澳門羽毛球格林披治黃金大獎賽組委會主席龐達才先生
Mr. Kong Tak Choi, President of Badminton Federation of Macau and President of the Organizing Committee of the 10th 2015 Macau Open Badminton out of the BWF Grand Prix Golf Series
澳門特別行政區政府體育發展局代表胡友賢先生
Mr. Leo Representative of Macau Sports Development Board of Macau Special Administrative Region.
Absolute Protect Sport 有限公司董事张建宏先生
Mr. Ronnie Chung, Managing Director of Absolute Protect Sports Limited.
麻煩三位現在就請運動員進場
Now let's welcome the winners to the stage.
2015 澳門羽毛球格林披治黃金大獎賽女子雙打的亞軍
The runners-up of women's doubles of the 10th 2015 Macau Open Badminton part of the BWF Grand Prix Gold Series goes to
是來自中國香港的潘樂欣和謝影雪組合
Poon Lok-yen and Zi Ying Su from Hong Kong, China
2015澳門羽毛球格林披治黃金大獎賽女子雙打的冠軍
The champion of women's double of the 10th 2015 Macau Open Badminton part of the BWF Grand Prix Gold Series goes to
是來自韓國的鄭景銀和新星贊組合
Young King Yoon, Shin Sing Chen from Korea
我們現在先請澳門羽毛球總會會長兼2015澳門羽毛球格林披治黃金大獎賽組委會主席邝达才先生同我們頒發獎牌
Now may we invite Mr. Kyung Choi, President of Badminton Federation of Macau and President of the Organizing Committees of the 10th 2015 Macau Open Badminton, part of the BWF Grand Prix Gold Series, to award the medals.
我哋有請 Absolute Protect Sport 有限公司董事張建宏先生同我哋頒贈鮮花
Now may we invite Mr. Ronnie Chung, Managing Director of Absolute Protect Sports Limited to award the flowers
我哋有請澳門特別行政區政府體育發展局代表胡友月先生頒發獎金支票
Now may we invite Mr. Wu Youyue, Representative of Macau Sports Development Board of Macau SAR, to award the prize money
有請三位嘉賓同埋運動員拍照留念
May we invite our guests to take the group photos with the winners
Well, nice that they shared the podium together. Obviously, our thoughts go to C's partner, Poon, and we wish her well. But I suppose congratulations are in order to their opponents, Jung and Shin. Another title for them without actually winning a match.
係各位球迷，咁我哋咧都希望咧就係同鄭景銀啦，同埋新星站佢哋傾傾偈嘅。
Well, here's the highlights from the match, which obviously we know how it ended. Pain and agony. So that's four of our finals completed, one still to come, the men's doubles. So, the men's doubles, and here's how our four players got to the final from the quarter-final stage. Very angry Alvin and Ryan Agung Saputra. As you can see, they've had three setters all the way.